I was really upset. I felt violated.
Susan Strand is talking about this letter she received in the mail from a group called Northern California Voter Project. The letter includes a chart with names showing Susan who voted in her neighborhood and who didn't, with a warning that her name might be on the list if she fails to vote in the upcoming special election for state Senate on June 4th.
I did not know that some of our information is available to the public, but I really felt like this was an invasion of my privacy.
The address for Northern California State Voter Project is just a P.O. box at the West Sacramento Post Office, where ownership records are considered confidential. But the group's hidden message of outing non-voters is troubling to Kim Alexander of the California Voter Foundation.
It's telling voters, we're watching you, we know if you're voting, we know if your neighbors are voting, and it's trying to vote shame people into voting, and that's just not the way to go.
The state assembly is the battlegrounds for Senate District 1, where Brian Dolley and Kevin Kiley, both Republicans, are vying for an empty seat vacated by Ted Gaines. The Kiley campaign denies any involvement in the mailers. The Dolley campaign did not return our phone calls. And while it's not clear who sent the anonymous mailers, California's top election official, Alex Padilla, sent us this statement today. It says, the Secretary of State's office is reviewing whether this mailing violates state election law. Whoever is sending the mailers is spending a lot of money, according to Paul Mitchell of Political Data, a bipartisan data vendor.
And a mailing like this probably costs anywhere from 70 cents to a dollar to actually produce and send out. And so if you're sending out 20,000 or 30,000 of these, you're talking about spending tens of thousands of dollars.